I bought a bunch of these Meross smart switches from Amazon to control lights and devices around Mr. Brown's basement. They all worked very well until this one stopped working. In the Meross app and the home app, the switch was unreachable. It appears to be completely dead. There are no obvious ways to open this up to get inside. I used a couple of small screwdrivers to non-destructively pry the case halves apart. There's not much inside, really. The board holds a microcontroller, some passive parts, and a relay. The front plate with the switch and the status indicator have an IDC connector that can easily be unplugged. Since it's dead, I'm going to infer that the issue is in the power supply. That should be easy to trace out. It's straightforward. A current limiter, a couple of diodes, a couple of capacitors, and a choke power the microcontroller. One of these components must be bad. Let's hope it's not the microcontroller. I grabbed my ohmmeter and started checking the diodes in the choke. Guess what? Diode D117 reads open in both directions. That's the problem. It's marked M7, which is a 1N4007 1-amp silicon diode. There's not a lot of current going through it. Why did it die after 3 years? Because it could. I didn't even bother firing up the hot air workstation. With some desolder wick and a couple squirts of flux, I was able to replace it with a soldering iron. Since the circuit is operating at line voltage and is not isolated, safety precautions must be taken.
And surprise, surprise, it's powering up. So the only thing that was wrong with it was a bad diode.
I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please click the like button and subscribe to Miss Brown's Basement. As always, thanks for watching.